Okay, Grandpa. Here's Marincin. Gets it across. Scores! Nylander. Open on the offside. Put it in the back door, and the Leafs grab the lead.
Well, we see this in hockey so often. You get the big save at one end, and then you come right back at the other. And there's the poke check we talked about on Simmons. What a play by Bernier to read that. Caught him with his head down. And then Marincin here with a beautiful pass through the seam. And how encouraging has the play of Nylander been of late as he's starting to light it up statistically again. And he bangs it in past Mason in a horrible defensive read by the Philadelphia Flyers. And you think they were tight before? They might be a little tighter now over there in that Philadelphia bench.
Knocked down, and away comes Nylander. Gets it up. Greening gets a chance. Gets a goal. Colin Greening. Right down Main Street. Or right down Broad Street.
And how hot is he? That's four now in his last four games as the coach for the Flyers. Boy, oh boy, he's got to be wondering what's going on. The Flyers here in their own zone get caught with all three forwards up the ice, and then the defense are standing still, not staggering. And what a play by Nylander to find Colin Greening out of the zone. And again, the speed of the Maple Leafs is totally eating up Philadelphia in this first period. And what a wonderful finish by Colin Greening.
Now the stick played ahead. Gagne looking for Couturier. Couturier. Back out in front. They score. What a pass by Couturier. And the finish by Braden Shen. And the Flyers are on the board. It's 2-1.
Well, the coach had that look of determination, and the players went out and executed. Mike Babcock looks on, and the Philadelphia Flyers are on the board in this one. Outstanding job from one end to the other. Maple Leafs attempted high stick there by Bozak. The Flyers track it down, and Couturier makes an outstanding backhand pass to the backhand of Braden Shen.
Well, the Flyers did exactly what their coach wanted there. Went to the front of the net, put the puck towards it, and they had a net drive with a great redirection by Braden Shen on a terrific feed by Couturier. Simple hockey.
Third line checker.
In over the line, Giroux. Look at this. Gets right in there. Rebound. Scores. Marichak. No goal. Waved off.
Philadelphia's using the coach's challenge, saying there is no goal interference prior to the goal.
There's the move. He loses his footing. Bernier gets taken out, and the puck goes in the net. I don't see how this can be a goal. But there's been some funny calls of late concerning this goalie interference. And I must admit, the last week or two, I've been confused with more than a few of them.
Here we go.
After video review, the call on the ice stands. There is goaltender incidental contact in the crease. No goal.
I would agree.
Simmons looks around, gets it back, holds intended for Goff's despair, knocked down, and off to the races. Grabner in there, scores! Michael Grabner, and the Leafs go up 3-1.
Well, Grabner's percentages on breakaways this year has not been probably great. He's had a ton of them because of his unbelievable speed. But this time, a real good play. Simmons will take it back to the point. Whoops. And that's why Simmons is so upset going to the bench, as he gave the puck away. And Grabner just outweights Mason, waits till he's deep in the net, slows his momentum down, and then just pulls it back and tips it over his glove. And you look at Steve Mason's game tonight. He was so good last night. Not that you can fault him, and look at Simmons' reaction afterwards. Not that you can fault him for the goals.
Here's a steal. Mandeveldi. Valar in front for White. Chopped away. Back up. McDonald. Wake fires and scores! Of course, it would be Andrew McDonald getting the goal. Flyers within one. McDonald's first of the season at the NHL level. It's 3-2.
Great decision by Dave Hakstol as he gets the fourth line guys out there, and they go to work again in the offensive zone. They have been the most effective line on the forecheck, and it pays huge, huge dividends here. White with the screen, McDonald with the elevated shot. Bernier can't come up with it. The Flyers are back in it.
That's a great shot by McDonald right there. Screened a little bit, perhaps by Brad Boyce. Short side, that's a great goal. Look at the excitement right there. Andrew McDonald, 11:27 to go. Plenty of time to get another.
It will be coming. Out in front, Shin with a chance, and nice stop by Bernier, one of his finest of the evening. A save of substance right there.
He was well tied up, now it's straight across ice. Takes it back, go wide.
Fire, deflection, score! Wayne Simmons redirects, and the Flyers have tied it at three. Less than a minute to go, and they tie the game at three, and this place goes crazy.
Great job by Dave Haxtell, an outstanding job of getting his number one power play unit ready to go on the ice when he pulled the goaltender. He rested Braden Shen. Shen missed a shift, and the guys that are most familiar with playing with a man advantage end up scoring the tying goal here. Outstanding stuff. Here goes Braden Shen to join his regular guys. With the man advantage, the goaltender's pulled, the Flyers with an extra attacker, and Simmons goes to work in front of that. Outstanding puck movement, Shen at the top, Simmons there with the redirection, and the Flyers tie it late.
Yeah, the shot's the right play here because there's a net presence right there. Simmons is there, he's got the beat, the inside of the two Leaf defensemen. Great shot, great redirection, this place is rock.
Gardner, bullseye! Jake Gardner with the winner in overtime. And the Flyers are left dumbfounded.
And the Leafs really moving around well here as they fresh bodies on the ice. And there's Gardner with the shot. And we're going to review this. They can't. So what's going to, I mean, the refs are going to look at it. Let's have a look and see here. Lake in front of the net. And I think this is going to be a good goal. They're looking at it right now, the officials. But for me, Lake is not in the blue paint.
Well,
yes he is. Yes he is. This is going to be interesting. At first I thought until I saw the overhead. And Mason immediately asked the official for a ruling. So the officials now looking at it at the penalty box. They can, of course, look at this particular play in overtime. Now, Lake gets pushed in. But does he try to get out? And for me, I don't think he does. And this will be interesting. Here comes the announcement.
After review, the